Today we are going to talk about, is beating really allowed in Islam? A lot of people would have come with an argument by saying that beating a woman is prohibited and it's strictly not allowed in Islam. So we will just go into a little detail and see what does the Islamic sources say about this. I'm going to read two verses from the Quran. Let's see what they say. I'm going to read chapter 4, which is Surah Al-Nisa, and then verse number is 34. It says, as to those women, on those part ye fear disloyalty and ill conduct, admonish them first. Now the first is in the bracket. It means that it's showing you have a level for the torture, you have a level towards the punishment. A small punishment, and then a bigger, and then the bigger punishment, and then the biggest punishment. But this is not in the Quran. They just put things in the bracket, add words to just mislead. But let's see in black and white what exactly this verse is talking about. It says, admonish them. And then it says, refuse to share their beds. And then it says, beat them. And the word lightly there is basically added just to, you know, show us that it's lightly. But the word in Arabic is not there, lightly, which means you can beat your wife. So this verse clearly shows us this beating wife is allowed. Now let's talk about another verse. Now this is Quran 38 verse 44. And take in thy hand a little grass and strike therewith. Now the question is, how the hell can you beat a wife with a little grass? That's not beating. You take a little grass and sprinkle in the ear, you know, like beating, probably. Think that could be the Prophet of God telling people to beat his wife? So here's the Quran talking about completely ordered from God that you're allowed to beat a wife. Let's talk about what the Islamic scholars, when they preach in the mosque, what do they say, how to beat a wife?
You should not beat her in the face.
This is according to the Quran. You cannot ask someone to reconsider the Quran. This doesn't work, then light beating is allowed. These recommendations are according to Quran and Sunnah, the Prophet's teachings. No one can dispute that.
لا تضرب الوجه ولا تقبح وأنت تضرب لا تقب لا تسب ولا تشتم يا ابنة كذا أنت كذا لا ممنوع هذا في
طيب
الإسلام
يا مولانا يضربها بإيه؟
يضربها نعم
بعصا
صحيح بإيه؟ عصا قصيرة وإذا ضربها لا يضربها على وجهها ولا على أماكن الرأس التي تؤذي بل يضربها على بدنها ويفرق الضرب كل هذا اختيار سابقة كمن تكريم الإسلام للمرأة أنه لم يجز العقوبة بالضرب كما قال أهل العلم إلا في حالة واحدة عند امتناعها عن فراشه
عربي کہتی کہ عورت میں چونکہ تھوڑی سی تیڑ ہے مرد زیادہ سمجھدار بردبار ہوتا ہے وہ اچھے سے اس کو ڈیل کر سکتا ہے لہٰذا اگر اس کی اصلاح کے لیے اگر تھوڑا سا وہ اس کو ضرب لگا لے تھوڑی سی اگر مار کرے تو شریعتاً انشاءاللہ اس میں کوئی خبات نہیں ہے
بناتے ہیں نا آسمان پہ اس قانون کا کوئی آلٹرنیٹ نہیں ہوتا کوئی متبادل نہیں ہے اس کا دوسری بات یہ کہ مرد کو اگر ہاتھ اٹھانے کی بالکل بھی اجازت نہ دی جائے تو پھر عورت جو مرضی کرتی رہے گی
beat on the face, there should not be any mark, somewhat similar to beating with a miswak. She says that yet she doesn't agree. How can somebody have the right to beat me? Sister, I'm asking a simple question. Suppose if you have a son and you live in a 9-story building and your son wants to jump from the 9-story building. He wants to jump and he wants to argue with you. What will you do? If you tell him don't jump, yet he wants to jump, what will you do? Sister, what will you do?
I will hit him.
So indirectly, this guy is saying that a woman is stupid as a child. Muslims often come to me and say that Islam is a religion, the only religion that gives women the most highest respect from anything else. Let us go into Islamic sources and see how respectable is the woman of Islam. When we come to this hadith, the reference is down there, you can check. Allah's Messenger said, if the husband calls his wife to his bed to have sexual relation and she refuses and causes him to sleep in anger, the angels will curse her till morning. So what if a woman just came from work or anything, or she just worked a lot at home, she's tired and she wants to go to sleep? It doesn't matter how tired you are, because when a man wants it, you better give him, because Islam is made for men only. You all might say that I'm not interpreting the hadith in the right way. If you don't believe me, watch this and you will believe me then.
بالضرب كما قال أهل العلم إلا في حالة واحدة عند امتناعها عن فراشه.
صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے جامعہ صغیر کے اندر یہ روایت آتی ہے، آپ نے فرمایا جب شوہر اپنی بیوی کو بلائے، ہم بستری کے لیے بلائے، تو عورت پر واجب ہے کہ وہ فوراً اس کی بات مان لے. آیت میں آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے صحیح بخاری کی روایت، آپ نے فرمایا جب شوہر اپنی بیوی کو ہم بستری کے لیے بلائے اور بیوی انکار کر دے اور شوہر اپنی بیوی سے ناراضگی کی حالت میں سو جائے تو ساری رات، اور اگر وہ سوتا رہے ساری رات اگر ناراض رہے، تو اس عورت پر صبح تک کے لیے فرشتے لعنت بھیجتے رہتے ہیں، فرشتے بددعائیں بھیجتے رہتے ہیں جو عورت اس طرح سے کرے.
Because Muhammad is the biggest preacher of Islam, let's see what Muhammad has to say about this. It's the Prophet said, who said? The Prophet said, no one should be asked or to be questioned as how and why he beat his wife. So you're not supposed to ask how to beat a wife. Like, you can do the kung fu, you can, if you have some karate skills, you can use on your wife. And it says, why do we beat your wife as well? Do not ask the question, why? You mean you can, this means you cannot ask a man how to beat a wife, and also why to beat a wife. For instance, if a man comes home, didn't make dinner for him, what is the man supposed to do? Just beat her? But don't ask him why, because the Prophet said, do it, because the Prophet said. Let's see another example in the hadith where a woman came to Muhammad and her skin was greener than her green veil. She was wearing a green veil. And her husband beat her so bad that her skin basically turned greener than the veil she was wearing. So what did Muhammad do? Let's see.
So this hadith was actually prove us that did Muhammad promoted men to beat his wife? Because in this hadith, there is a case that Muhammad had to see. In this case, there is a woman. She came to Muhammad, who was beaten up by her husband, and her skin was greener than her veil. Now, she was wearing a green veil. I want you to just imagine how brutally this woman was beaten by her husband, that her skin was so green, greener than her clothes. And then what happened? If you notice, if this would be a prophet of God, he would have at least told once to the husband, do not beat her, don't do physical assault on her. But Muhammad never said that. Actually, when the woman said to Muhammad that my husband is impotent, he cannot satisfy me sexually, like always, Islam is a religion of men. That is why the Prophet took side of the men and told her to go back to your husband.
So the question comes up, when Islam teaches about beating the wife, is it really a scenario when Muhammad had to face this? What happened when Muhammad basically was teaching about beating his wife? Did he ever actually beat his wife, or did he forgive her? Let's talk about this.